about how one decision can have incredible ramifications. Mitch McConnell decides to block Obama on Justice Scalia dies, and it just rolls and rolls, helps elect Trump. And what it also did was lead to Donald Trump being able to appoint Brett Kavanaugh to replace Anthony Kennedy. Brett Kavanaugh was Justice Kennedy didn't want to get the court out of this issue. Brett Kavanaugh was happy to do it. And I just think that this, you know, when people look at the court now, they hold these decisions to the end because they know they're very problematic. And they look at the court and they go, that was quite a political decision there. Now, Justice, Chief Justice Roberts is a kind guy, right? He gets the Republicans in the court. He's worried about the image of the court. So he sort of maneuvers a decision on the census question. So he kind of kicks that back so they didn't have two really Republican favorable decisions come out at one time. But I think the problem with the court right now is that it's at a dangerous point. People are starting to wonder if the court can make an objective decision. And when you see these big headlines, court allows, you know, partisan gerrymandering, I think that it's going to be reflected in public confidence in the court.
What about partisan gerrymandering? We've seen it in places, kind of Republican states like North Carolina, in Democratic states like Maryland. Does it mean it just continues now in states like that? If you have a red legislature, the districts are drawn by Republicans. If it's blue state, districts are drawn by Democrats.
Yes, and to an extent, that's always been the way, right? To the victors, go the spoils. If your party is in control of the state house, those are the things that you get to do. These cases involve really extreme partisan gerrymandering to a point that raised constitutional questions. And to be sure, right now, it's mostly Republican districts across the country that are doing it because the more state houses are controlled by them. And they sort of forged that plan. A lot of issues, you brought up racial gerrymandering, which is unconstitutional. If you do a Venn diagram of partisan and racial gerrymandering, they overlap a lot. And so one fear is that when racial gerrymandering claims are brought, the lawmakers are going to come back and say, no, it's not racial gerrymandering, it's just partisan gerrymandering.
Many civil rights groups have expressed that thought this week, that partisan gerrymandering really...
Sabrina!
Republicans control most of the state legislatures in this country. Does this decision, partisan gerrymandering, raise the stakes for 2020 for Democrats to try to come back in the states?
Absolutely. I mean, it raised the stakes in 2018 in the gubernatorial races, and Democrats were able to take back a number of state governorships that they had lost in 2010 and didn't win back in 2014. In those states, particularly where governors have power over, they now have a way to check the Republican legislature, and Republicans at this point hold many, many more. Republicans have been much more effective over the last 10 to 12 years in focusing on state legislative races, and Democrats are trying to get back.